Hey guys, this is Jay here, and in this video I'll show you how to create a good looking website not with Wix but with WordPress. So without any further ado, let's get started. So let's start. It all starts with the domain name, and the best trick I have to buy a good domain for cheap is go on Google, search for ₹99 domain or dollar domain, and you'll find several domain registrars offering you your first domain for ₹99. So here is namecheap.com. They are offering me my first domain for $0.88, and they are also offering me free WhoisGuard protection. So if you don't have WhoisGuard protection, what will happen? So basically, if somebody searches for you on Whois with the domain name, they can see all the information that was given by you to the domain registrar, like your name, number, address. So if you need to hide that, then you need to buy Whois protection, but namecheap.com is giving you that for free. I have already bought a domain called ataglance.in, so let's continue with that. And after buying the domain, it's time to buy hosting for it. So I'll only recommend you guys DigitalOcean because they give you dedicated droplet for $5, and almost all other hosting sites come under the umbrella of AIG and they all suck. You can read more about this scam from the link down below in the description. So if you are signing up for DigitalOcean, I will request you guys to do it from the link down below. I'll get a small referral fee and that will help me support this channel. So after signing up for DigitalOcean, you have to do billing verification. Basically, you have to add your credit or debit card so that they can be assured that you won't run away after using their service. So just add a credit debit card. Or if you want to go the prepaid way, then you can deposit $5 from your PayPal account. So do whatever works for you, and if your card is not working for some reason, you can go to entropy.com and generate a virtual credit card. So pay them $6 and they will give you a card worth of $5, and you can use that here. Once you have done billing verification, you can apply promo codes now. I will leave some really good promo codes in the description down below so that you can get the most out of it. So I just used this DO10 promo code and I got $10 worth of credit. That means that I can run my server for free for 2 months. So let's now create a droplet. So I'll just click on this green button and the distribution is perfect. Let's leave it as it is. For the location, I'll choose Singapore or Bangalore because most of my site's visitors will be from India or around India. So I'll just do that, and in the additional options I'll just select monitoring because that will give me additional monitoring metrics in my dashboard. So in the end I'll just give my server a name and click on create. Once the droplet is created, I'll simply copy the droplet IP and launch terminal on my Mac. If you are on Windows, then you need to install the software called PuTTY in order to communicate with the server. So once you are in the terminal, type ssh space root at the rate and paste your droplet IP here and then press enter. It will ask for a password and that password is in your email. So check your email, copy the password, paste it here, press enter, enter the password again, set a new password, and that's it. We are now in the server. Now we will leave all the hard work to the guys at easyengine.com to do it. And we'll just copy paste and do the smart work. So go to easyengine.com, copy the first command, paste it here, press enter. It will ask you for your name and email, so just enter that and press enter. And this will take quite a time, so in the meanwhile we'll connect our domain to our hosting because we bought the domain from a different website and we bought the hosting from a different one. So we need to create a link between them. So first of all, we'll go to our DigitalOcean dashboard, go into networking and add a domain here. We'll just type @, we'll point it to our droplet ID and reduce the TTL time to live to 600 seconds and click on save. And if you want your visitors to access your site's www version also, then you need to create one more A record. This time type www instead of @, and the rest is the same. Now we have to go to our domain registrar and change the name server. So I bought this domain from GoDaddy, so I'll go to GoDaddy, go to my products, go to my domains and select this domain and click on DNS. Change the name server to default to custom and I'll add ns1.digitalocean.com and ns2.digitalocean.com. So once this is done, let's go back to terminal now. It's time to paste the second command, so copy it and paste it here. But wait, don't press enter because we have to change example.com with our domain name. So let's just do that. And we will add a couple of flags also. To see the list of all the flags, you can check the documentation. So we will add FC after WP because that will install WordPress with fast CGI caching. That will drastically improve the site loading time and performance. And I will also add one more flag, which is --php7, because I have heard that PHP 7 is way faster than PHP 5.6, which is installed by default. And I will also add --letsEncrypt to install SSL certificate. After the process is complete, you'll get your WordPress username and password here. So please take a screenshot, please take a note of this, and with this you can log in to your site. It's very simple to log in into a WordPress dashboard. Just type your domain and type slash, then type wp-login.php. So let's start where we left from. Chances are, if you added the flag --letsEncrypt, you ended up getting an error. Don't worry, it never worked for me also. So your WordPress is installed, but we have to add SSL certificate manually. So for that, we'll just type sudo add apt repository ppa certbot slash certbot. Then we'll type sudo apt get update, and then we'll type sudo apt get install python certbot nginx. And then in the end, we'll type sudo certbot --nginx to execute the command. Then I'll just type my email and press enter. And we'll just press enter to select both the versions of the domain. Then we'll redirect all the traffic, so we'll just type 2 and press enter. That's it. HTTPS is installed on your site. Now we'll just log in, and the first thing that I do after installing WordPress is to change the theme ASAP with my favorite one. So I'll just go to themeforest.net, I'll choose a premium theme and buy it. But there is also a free theme that I really like the most. It's called Page Speed and it's by Satish Gandham. So if you want a really good high speed theme and you don't want fancy stuff, you can go with this theme. The best thing about this theme is it's super fast. It scores 100 out of 100 on Google's Page Speed test, which is fantastic. So I've already bought a theme called Javelin, and yes, again, if you're going to buy a theme or anything from the Envento marketplace, please use my link in the description. I'll get a small referral fee that will help me support this channel and do less sponsored videos. So after installing the theme, I'll install all the necessary plugins that are needed to run this theme properly. So I'll just bulk install them, and once it's done, I'll find an option that will allow me to import the demo content. It usually is in the themes plugin. For this theme, it's in the Unison plugin. So after importing the demo content, you have to just customize, customize, and customize. Replace this logo with your logo, replace these images with your own images, replace these posts with your post, customize these widgets, header, footer, right sidebar, everything. Customize these menu links, so you'll see the menu here, header menu, footer menu, all the menus. Customize these social links, so when people will click on this Facebook icon, they should go to your fan page instead of the theme's fan page. Now customize, customize, and customize, and once you're done with everything, it's time to install some useful plugins. So there are four WordPress plugins that I recommend installing right away. The first one is Facebook Comments, so just click on add new, search for Facebook Comments, install it, activate it, and so just go into the settings of the Facebook Comments and add your app ID here. You can get the app ID for free. So once you add it, so once you add the app ID and click on save, you'll see this Facebook Comments bar on every post. The second plugin is Post Updated plugin. Basically, if you install this plugin, your audience will be able to see when this post was last updated. The third plugin is AMP. AMP stands for Accelerated Mobile Project. So for example, your user is on very low bandwidth, 2G. So this plugin will strip down everything that is consuming users' data, and it will show the bare minimum basic version of the site. And Google heavily promotes this AMP thing, so if your site has AMP support, it will rank better and you'll get more traffic. And I will also recommend you to install any plugin that enables WhatsApp sharing on your post. So just search for WhatsApp share, try a few plugins and see what you like. And the last plugin that I recommend installing is iTheme Security, because it will help you tighten up the security of your site. Now we are done with the plugins, now we'll just install push notification support to our site. So for that we'll just go to onesignal.com, sign up there, add a new app, select WordPress. They'll give us two keys, so just copy them and go back to your site, add their plugin, OneSignal plugin. So just go into your plugins, click on add new, search for OneSignal, activate it, paste these keys and customize options as you like, and just click on save. And now you'll get this pop-up on your site so that people can enroll in your notification system, and your readers will be automatically notified when the next time you publish a post. So that's it for this video guys, thank you so much for watching this video till the end. Don't forget to share it with your friends, and I will see you in the next one.